Welcome back to Score on Business. So, Lucas, let's get back to it. Talk to us a little bit about security.
Sure. So I think it's funny, in this day and age where there's so many security enhancements every single month coming out from companies, stronger firewalls, stronger security platforms, it really boils down to two things that I think most companies can do themselves.
Right.
That are typically the loopholes that are exploited.
Yeah.
And the first thing that a company can do is just better password management, following better password policies, like try not to use the same password in multiple websites and accounts.
And also, what are some tools that would help?
Yeah, so there's a lot out there. My favorite for small teams is 1Password.
Mm-hmm. That's the name of the product, is 1Password.
Yeah, and it's very definitive. It defines itself, too.
Yeah.
The idea is that you kind of create one master password, and you store every other password
in there,
in this little like lockbox, if you will.
Yeah.
And so whenever you visit a website, you can have 1Password autofill that website. Now, if you really trust the app, you can actually let it generate random passwords for you. So I couldn't even tell you my passwords for most of the websites I use because I trust 1Password to just autofill the right one for me.
You know, I do that as well, and it tells me when they need to change. It can auto-change some of them, but my passwords are all 20 characters and a jump, unless there's a restriction.
Right.
Okay, and then what about two-factor authentication?
Bingo. So that's the second one. When you're shopping for a cloud service or some kind of application for your company, you really want to make sure it has two-factor authentication.
Yeah.
And what this does is it basically prevents the ability for someone overseas or in a different location from you from hacking your password.
Right.
Because without two-factor, there's only one key. There's 1Factor, right?
They
can, if they get that password, they can log in.
Yeah.
But with two-factor authentication, it adds a second variable to that login process, and that usually that second variable is your cell phone.
Right.
And so what they'll do is text you a code to your cell phone to verify that the person who's attempting to log in is you, right? So then you just enter that little 4 or 6 digit number to verify that you in fact are the one logging in.
Mm-hmm.
So just by having two-factor authentication turned on, that make sure that you are the only person that's ever going to try to log into that account.
Okay, so we got a couple of minutes left. Let's talk about entrepreneurship.
Sure.
And you know, you started Fuji and it's growing now. You're in some different cities. Tell us, what would you tell starting entrepreneurs?
Awesome. So, you know, I think the most important thing at the very beginning is to make sure that you have a product that people want. Right? As fun as it is doing what we're doing, you really need to define that use case. And that's why I'm a huge fan of bootstrapping your business. It not only defines that there's a real market for it when you're kind of relying on that money, but when you're bootstrapped, it gives you an opportunity to really, it gives you that motivation to get better at earning money, if that sounds weird. You know, just like any trade or sport that you want to improve.
No, you prove that it's going to work.
You improve over time. And I think a lot of businesses could really do better by improving that craft of earning money. Listening to your customers. It really gets down to basics. Trying new methods. And so by being bootstrapped, you're more motivated to improve that cash flow.
And you know, companies are going to have a hard time getting money if they don't have something.
Right.
But funding is not free. I mean, you have a new master when you have.
Absolutely, and that's the second reason why.
Hey, we're almost out of time for today. So, hey, ladies and gentlemen, thanks so much for being here this week, and we'll be back next week. Okay, thanks for being here, Lucas.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah.